Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. You can see here, it's a sunset with a wooden bridge on the top of these cliffs. It will not be easy for the beginners, but it will be very challenging for them. And please don't forget to subscribe it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials we need for this tutorial on the screen. I have there the 5 limited colors. I also have here the brushes and some other materials that we need to paint this tutorial. Okay, so I'm gonna start now. And first step, I'm going to do the sketching. I'll be using the number 2 nylon flat brush. We have here the raw umber and white. Okay. So it's very important. I'm gonna put some white so that it will be lighter and it will be easier for me to cover the other paints, especially yellow. Okay. This will be the part of the bridge here. And here. Okay. This will be a really huge bridge. I think you can do it, everyone. It will not be so difficult, I think. So we're gonna do the sketching so that we will know where we're gonna put all these things, especially those details. I'm gonna put more rock. I will put the light here in the center. It will be glowing of light. And it will be the bridge will be like this. A little curve on the top. It will be a footbridge. And some woods here, woods there. Okay, so we have now the sketching. We have now the sketch, sorry. And we're gonna do the background colors. Okay, so I will make it very colorful. Want some blue and red, purple, more blue and white. More red. This will be a light purple, everyone. I'm gonna make a little colorful skies, like greenish colorful skies. I'll try to put more red, violet, like or pink. I want to put a really beautiful sky here. Yeah, I want to put more pink. So don't worry everyone, this is still the underpainting. I want this really pink sky. I want it because it looks really good. one more pink. And then on the bottom, I want it to be more like orange. So I want this yellow and red. And then white. Colors there. Yeah, I like to put more yellow on this part, because I want this part to be really glowing with yellow. And then also, I'll try to put more yellowish reflections on water. Yellow with a little orange or red. There, and then I will try to put some raw umber. Some little bugs. And also here. Don't worry about it. This is just the first step, which is the underpainting or the background colors. I'm gonna put more a little bluish color here. There, and then I'll try this blue stone. I'll try to put some more, like some forest on the back, but I want it to be a little more purple. There. Okay, also here. Okay, and then I'll try to use this more bluish or purple with some umber to put some reflection. Okay, you can just create some downward strokes like this. There. You can now see some reflections, yeah. I'm gonna put a little bluish color. And also here, I'm gonna put a huge will be a huge cliff here on this part. There, so we have now done, we're now done in the second step, which is the putting the underpainting. Yeah, it's very easy, everyone. And we're gonna let it a little, let it dry first for a little, like 5 or 10 minutes. Okay, everyone. So I am going to continue. I think it is already dry. Yeah, and I'm going to extend a little here because I think for me this is just short. Yeah, it's okay, everyone. If you try to correct something or something is you want to improve, that's fine. If you just retouch and try to improve or something like that. Okay, so here I'm going to extend here a little. Yeah, will be here. Okay, and also the other one. There, so I have now some good guide. Okay, I'll put some few huge rock here. Although this will be dark here because the light coming from here, but it's fine. I want the center to be really focused on the lights. Okay, so I will now start putting some clouds. So here I am using the number 8 flat brush, red and blue to make purple and white. Make some reddish purple. Adding more white. Okay, that's too bright. I'm going to make it a little darker. Yeah. I just want to put beautiful clouds there. I'm gonna put a little white. Okay, and now I'm going to put more red and white. More white. Okay. I'll put a little like a smoke here, but it's a clouds, everyone. Look like smoke. There. Yeah, just to make it a little more dirty. Okay. And of course, I'm going to put some red. I want it to be pink in color. Of pink clouds. There. Not just pink, but I'm going to put some orange. I think I will be using a smaller brush now. The number 2 flat brush, so I'm gonna mix for orange and white. So it should be more orange or yellowish here because it will be directly hit by the sun. Put it under. Yeah. There, I want it to be more bright. Or brighter, yellow and white. I want to make this part really bright because I want to put the light here, or yeah, I think just here. Yeah, I think I will put the sun hiding on this part. Okay, and then I'll try to make some orange clouds. Yeah, maybe some purple mountains. Make it a little darker, more red. Now, of course, we're gonna put some reflection on this one. Just copy everything you see there and put it down. So I'm gonna put reflection, copy everything, and just also copy the colors. I put a little gap here so that it will be a little light here. Yeah. There. And I'll try to use some yellow or orange. Cause I'm gonna make this part more like an orange color, because the sun is coming from this part. I'm gonna make it a little more orange. There. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I really like those colors there. It really looks pretty. Looks pretty awesome. And then using this orange. It should be a lot more lighter, everyone. I'm gonna put some highlights here on this part of the on the tree, but I want it to be darker. The highlight should be more orange or reddish. And then I'll try to put more like a lighter orange, because this part should be very, very bright. It should look more bright here. There. I want it to be more orange, just yellow and red, everyone, and then put it there. And also here, I wanted to put a little orange. Okay. There. And I think I'm gonna make this dark, everyone. I think my middle is too bright. Also here. Yeah, maybe I'll put first some highlights. So I'll just use this raw umber with some yellow and red. It should be brownish and a little white. And then, of course, the other one also. Okay. This will be some sort of rocky. I'll try to put more raw umber and also yellow and red to make some orange. This one also. Okay. And then I will try to put some dark tones using this raw umber. Yeah, I can try the raw umber and blue, everyone. Yeah, you can put a little, just a little dark stuff. And of course this part here on the top, it should be dark. And here. Just make it darker one on the top. Yeah, it should be really, really look like a rocky mountain, rocky cliff or something like that. Okay, I think I like how it looks, everyone. Looks pretty, for me, it's just realistic. And also, I like the sunlight there. It really looks like growing. Okay, and then I'm going to put the bridge now. Maybe I'll just use, first the big brush. The number 2 flat brush, and then this whole amber with red. It should not be too bright, everyone. More red and yellow. I'm gonna try to put it here. Yeah, it should be a little curve. I'm gonna put a little perspective. There, we can put a little tiny things there. Yeah. Yeah. And then now, I'll try to, continue. More like another brown. Then we're gonna put some big. Trees here, like that. And also here. We should not. It's okay if that's so straight, everyone. That's fine. That's actually better. So it's hard to use a brush that has no good point, can choose a better brush, everyone. There, so you have no good foundation. I think this looks better. Okay, on the top I will put something like some something that you can hold when you go there, when you go on this bridge. I'll let her use some browns. Okay, I'm gonna put it on the top. There. Okay. And then you can put something that you can hold. Almost on the back. There. Oh my god. Sorry everyone, this part here is still wet and I tried to touch. Sorry. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Okay, and I'm going to put some bright lights there, but it should be more yellowish. So white and yellow. Yeah, it's white and yellow, but I'm going to put some highlights here. Just use the liner brush. And also here, I'm gonna put a little highlights. There, yeah. And then on the rocks also. I just want to emphasize more that this part is very bright. Okay. Yeah, so far I love it. Okay, and then I'm going to start putting the sun first. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put the sun here. I'm gonna put some very bright light on the back of this bridge, and then I'm gonna mix red and yellow to make some orange. Should be more orange, everyone. And then I'm gonna put it here. There. And this part here should look more glowing. Yeah. Can put like sun rays Yeah, I want to put more like now the highlights. And also some trees there. I wanted to put more trees. So I'll be using this bristle flat brush, and I'm going to use some yellow and red. Yeah, it should be orange. Or if you have Rosanna, that will be good. I'll try to put it here. Can use the tapping technique, everyone. And also here, I'll try to put some highlights. This. Some yellowish highlights, and also here on the top. There. And then also here, I'm gonna put a few. Trees, yeah, maybe bigger trees. There. Yeah, and then we're gonna mix for some greenish color, but not so green, everyone. I don't want to put more greenish, blue, yellow, and red. So this is the color, and more yellow, a little blue. Just put it in the center one. There. And also I need to put some trees here, or some plants here. You can use the punching or tapping technique. There. I'm gonna put more red and yellow, and I'm gonna put it here. So here, I'm gonna put some trees. Some plants. Yeah, I think I'll just put plants here. Yeah. Okay, and then another greens, blue, yellow, and red. I'm gonna put some tiny plants, and then also here make sure that it should be dark. I want to be darker. Yeah. And then another one here on the top. Okay, and then I'm going to use a smaller liner brush, because I'm gonna put some tree trunk and branches. Just use the liner brush, and then I'm gonna put some tree trunk here. Yeah, and then the other one here. Okay. Yeah, so far I really love the view, everyone. This looks really great. And then let's try to put more highlights. So using the number one liner brush and yellow and white, put the reflection here. Put some lines, everyone. Yeah. Okay. And then we're gonna need to put some purple clouds. So here I have some blue and red and white to make it purple. Yeah, just horizontal strokes, everyone, and you can create those purple clouds. There. Okay. Okay, what's next? I'm going to try to put more lights, and then I'm done. But first I'm going to do this one. I'm gonna put some darks, raw amber and blue. I just had to put some dark tones on this rock here. There, and then I'm going to improve the water. Blue, red, and yellow. But I want to put more red. Yeah, just horizontal strokes, everyone. Like it, and also here. It's a little bluish, and then that's fine. There. Okay. Yeah, I think that looks more. I think that looks realistic now. Okay, so I'm going to continue more. Yeah, I'll just put some highlights here, but I'll be using the smaller brush. Using the lighter. It's too wet. I just copy everything here, what you see. And then let's put it here. Make it more orange. Okay, it's now look realistic, and then of course we need to put those poles, or right, I'll be using the same color here. Okay. Yeah, I think I am now on the process of retouching, everyone. I will retouch as I'll retouch now. Yeah. But first I'm going to put some lighter color here, like pinkish color for the highlights from the sky. Here. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to retouch. I think I'm going to put a traveler here. I'll try to put a traveler on a horse, but I'll just put it in the dark color red. Yeah, that's a small one. You can see that he is traveling. Okay, so I'm going to retouch. I'm going to use this yellow here and white. I'll try to make this part glowing. Just touch everyone. That means the light is hitting this part. And also here. And the last part will be the highlights of the mountain. So red and yellow. This one, I'm gonna put a little tiny highlights. Just to show that this thing are huge rock. And then yellow and red for the three highlights and a little white. Just a little yellow one. I'm gonna put some greenish. I'll just try to show some more greens there. Okay, and then yellow. Okay. So I think I am done, everyone. So this is just very easy tutorial. I think everyone can do it also, and it is not so complicated. Just simple one, and I finish it for maybe 1 hour, and I love it. I love the result. Just simple, but I like the lights. It's really great, and you can really see it look realistic. Okay, everyone. So I wanna say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.